Good morning, students. Today's topic is representation of rational number on number line. How we can represent rational numbers on the number line. And what is proper and improper fraction? Improper fraction and proper fraction I have taught you in the fraction chapter, that whenever the numerator is less than the denominator, it is called proper, and whenever the numerator is more than the denominator, is called improper. Similarly, we have proper rational number and improper rational number. Okay, whenever the numerator is less than the denominator, it is called proper rational number, like 1/2, 4/5. You can see numerator is less than the denominator, -3/8. Okay, similarly, improper rational number, numerator is more than the denominator, then it is called like 7/4. You can see numerator is more than the denominator, it is called improper. Now there is different method to plot proper rational number and improper rational number on the number line. For this, first of all, we will learn how to plot the proper rational number. So students, proper rational numbers value always lies between 0 to 1, between this only, 0 to 1. You can divide and see half, it is half, it lies between 0 and 1. 4/5, its value also 0 point something, so its value also lies between 0 to 1. Similarly, all the proper rational number value lies between 0 to 1, you can divide and see. So, whenever we have to plot the proper rational number, we will draw a number line. The middle point, you know, that is 0. After this, you can plot 1, 2, 3, 4. This side -1, -2, -3, according to your need. But first of all, suppose I want to plot 1/2 on the number line. So, you have to see the denominator. Denominator is 2. So, we will divide 0 to 1 into 2 equal parts, like this. Suppose 0, you have to take this distance equally. Always remember, I am taking it right now like this, but you have to measure with the help of a scale. The same distance you have to take. Suppose 0 to 1 I have taken here to here, then similarly you have to take same distance 0 to after 1 to 2. This and this should be equal. Okay, similarly here also -1, -2, like this, but this is positive, so we will take positive side only, no need to write the negative. Okay, so 1/2, you have to see the denominator. Denominator is 2, so we will divide this 0 to 1, this segment, into 2 equal parts. This and this part should be equal. You will measure with the help of a scale. So 2 equal parts, because denominator is 2. Okay. Now, this part is called, this is 0. This part is called 1/2. This part is called 2/2. 2/2 will get cancelled. We will get 1 only. Okay. So, this part, middle part is half. So, this is the plotation of this point lies between 0 to 1 here. Suppose you have to plot 4/5. So, suppose you have to plot 4/5. So, again, this is a positive number. So, you can take 0 here. After this, 1, 2, 3, 4. If negative number will be there, then you have to take this side. Okay, minus side. But this is positive. So, you have to see the denominator. Denominator is 5. So, we will divide 0 to 1 into how many equal parts? 5 equal parts. So, according to your need, 1 we will take little more distance. 0 to 1. Then same distance 1 to 2. But there is no need of 2, because we are plotting the proper rational number and its value always lies between 0 to 1. So 0 to 1 I have taken. Now we will divide this into 5 equal parts. 1 part, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You have to measure, students, with the help of scale only. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this you will measure. Okay, I am taking it right now because my one hand is not free. So, I am not taking a scale, but you have to measure with the help of a scale only. Now, this first part is called 1/5. This is 2/5. This is 3/5. this is 4 by 5 and this part is 5 by 5. 5 by 5 will get cancelled, we will get 1. So actually it is 5 by 5, we write it as 1. Okay, but we have to plot 4 by 5. So which is the point? This point. Got it? Now suppose you have to plot minus 3 by 8. Minus 3 by 8 on the number line. Okay, this is also proper. So this is negative. So we will take 0 to minus 1. Minus 1 we will take here. This much, why I have taken the little bigger distance? Because denominator is 8. We have to divide this into 8 equal parts. You can see we have divided this into 8 equal parts. 1 part, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. This segment you have to count. Okay. Now this is called minus 1 by 8. This is called minus 2 by 8. This is called minus 3 by 8. Minus 4 by 8, minus 5 by 8, minus 6 by 8, minus 7 by 8, and this is minus 8 by 8, that will be equal to minus 1. Okay, now we have to plot minus 3 by 8. Where is minus 3 by 8? Here is minus 3 by 8. So this is our point. Got it? So these all were proper rational numbers. So it's all the values lies between 0 to 1. You can see. I have taken between 0 to 1 only. Okay. But what about improper fractions? Means improper rational number. Its numerator will be more than the denominator. Okay. So we will first change such types of improper into improper rational number into mixed fraction first. Okay. Let's see. These all are improper rational number. 7 by 4, 5 by 3, minus 7 by 5. We are going to plot it. Okay, 7 by 4 first. 7 by 4, first of all, we will change this into mixed fraction. How to change into mixed fraction? 4, 1, 4. So, 3 will be up. Remainder always goes up. And quotient always lies this side. 1, 3 by 4 is the mixed fraction of this. First work, we will change into mixed fraction. Okay. Now, what is this 1, 3 by 4? 1 whole 3 by 4. So, we will plot. This is positive. So, we will take 0. After that, equal distance. You can take 1 here. Then 2. Then 3. Then 4 like this. You can take equal distance. 1, 2, 3, 4. What is this? This is 1. 1 is a whole number. So, 1 is this. But what is this? 3 by 4. This is again a proper form, proper rational number. So 3 by 4 after 1, because it is 1 by 3. So after 1, we are going to plot this first. 3 by 4 means denominator is 4. So we will divide this segment into 4 equal parts. After 1, because this is whole number 4, after this only it is written. Okay. So 4 equal parts, 1. 2, 3, 4. 1 part, 2 part, 3 part, 4 part. Okay. This is called 1 by 4. This is called 2 by 4. This is called 3 by 4. Okay. So 1, 3 by 4 will be 1 after that 3 by 4. So this point will be equal to 1 whole 3 by 4. That is equal to 7 by 4. Got it? You will write it as 7 by 4. Understood? So let's see one more. Suppose 5 by 3 you have to plot. So we will first change this 5 by 3 into what? Mixed fraction. Change this 5 by 3. 3 1 ja 3. We will get here 2. So 2, 1 whole 2 by 3. This is also positive. So 1, 2, 3. 1 after 1, you have to take 2 by 3. So, denominator is 3. So, we will divide this segment into 3 parts. 1 part, 2 part, 3 part. Okay. And this is 1 by 3. This is 2 by 3. This is 3 by 3. Okay. So, 2 by 3. 1 whole 2 by 3 means this point. After 1, 1 whole 2 by 3. This is 5 by 3. This is the way you can plot the improper rational number. Suppose minus 7 by 5 you have to plot. So minus, so this we will take negative sides. So minus 7 by 5, first of all you change this into mixed fraction. Minus 7 by 5. 5 1 ja 5. We will get here 2. So 2 will go up and 5 will be down. 1 whole 2 by 5. Okay, 1 whole 2 by 5 you have to plot here. But in minus, because it is minus. So we will take minus 1, minus 2, like this. So 1 whole minus 1 whole 2 by 5. After 1 you will take 2 by 5. So 2 by 5 denominator is 5. So you will divide this into 5 equal parts. 1 part, 2 part, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now this is called minus 1 by 5. This is called minus 2 by 5. This is minus 3 by 5. This is minus 4 by 5. That will be next number. That is equal to means minus 5 by 5. That will be equal to 1 means next number. So 2 by 5. Where is 2 by 5? This is. So after 1 minus 1. 2 by 5. This will be the point. This is, you will write it as minus 7 by 5. This will be the point. I hope you have got it how to plot the improper and proper rational number on the number line. So you have the questions in your exercise, students. You can see question number 4. Draw a number line and represent the following rational number on it. 4 by 5. This is what? Proper. This is also proper. This is improper. So 4 by 5 right now only I have explained you. 4 by 5. Second number, this one. Okay. 3 by 8. I think 3 by 8 also I have explained, but in minus. Minus 3 by 8 I have explained. You can take to the same process in the plus side, because plus 3 by 8 given in your book. So plus 3 by 8 you will do this side, positive side. Minus 7 by 5, it is a improper. So improper also I have explained it. You can see minus 7 by 5. This one. Got it? So students, one more thing, that you can plot all these numbers on the same number line also. But I want you to draw each and every number in a separate number line as I have drawn. Okay? So that you can understand it better. After that, you can draw all these numbers in the same number line also, because it is given in your example. You can draw both the things you can do, but I want you to draw the separately so that you will understand better. Okay, for question number 5 is compare the following. You can compare it very easy. You can take the LCM of the denominator and make the denominator same as you have done before also in class 5 and 6. After that, which will be the greater? You can say this is greater or that one. Okay. These all are simple questions. You can do it. And what is a standard rational number, students? Standard rational numbers means standard form of a rational number. Suppose a rational number is written. This is a standard form. But if it is written minus 7 by 5, this is also a standard form. But if it is written 3 by minus 8, then this negative sign will never be in the denominator. It will be up. You can write it as minus 3 by 8. Okay, this is the standard form. Negative sign will always be with the numerator. Standard form of rational number. Got it? So next day I will discuss the addition and subtraction of rational number. Till then you have to complete exercise 4.1 properly in your notebook. Okay?